Here's how to use Audacity and record clean audio on your desktop. Use our clickable sections below to skip through different parts of this tutorial. When you open Audacity, you will see a blank project page. To save this new project, click File, Save Project As. To opening an existing project, click File, Open. Step 1. Choose your audio input. To select your audio source, click the drop-down menu next to the microphone icon and select the source you want to use. The program will have your device's built-in microphone selected by default. For most voiceover projects, you will want to record in mono. If you are tracking music or using multiple mics at a time, you will likely want to use stereo. For our purposes, we will continue with mono. It is recommended that you keep your project rate at 44,100 Hz unless you have a specific reason to change it. Make sure Audacity is playing the audio back through the correct device. To change your audio output, click the drop-down menu next to the volume icon and select the source you want to use. Set the volume of your audio clip using this slider next to the microphone symbol. You will generally want to keep your levels under minus 12 decibels in order to keep them from peaking. To control the playback volume on your headphones or speakers, use the scale next to the volume symbol. To start recording, click the red button in the upper left corner. Audacity will automatically create a new track. You can click pause to stop the recording in place. If you click the pause button again, the previous recording will continue. If you click stop, it will end your recording and bring the scrubber to the beginning of the recording. If you want to delete an audio track, press X at the top of the audio track. To create new tracks, select Tracks, Add New, and choose either mono or stereo. Step 4, editing tracks. To split your audio recordings, select the desired point in the recording and hold Command I or Control I on a PC. To move these split portions around within the track, select the Time Shift tool from the toolbar, highlight the portion that you want to rearrange, and slide it to the left or the right. Step 5. Balancing levels. To balance the audio levels of a recording, select the Envelope tool. You can drag these two blue borders up or down to adjust the master levels of the track. If you need to make very specific adjustments, click again at the beginning and end of the section to create independent control points, the small circles. You can drag these points up and down to adjust the volume. Noise reduction is an effect used to help remove or silence unwanted background noise. While this won't be very effective on harsh sounds such as dogs barking or car horns, it can reduce subtle sounds like hums, ceiling fans, or electronics. First, record 10 to 20 seconds of room tone. Room tone is the ambient noise of the room you're recording in. When you think you have enough room tone, keep the recording going until you're ready to jump right into your content. When you are done with the track, highlight the section with the room tone and click on Effect, Noise Reduction. A new window will pop up. Select Get Noise Profile. Then press Command A or Control A on a PC to select the entire track. With the whole track selected, click Effect, Noise Reduction, and select OK. To balance the bass and treble in your audio, select Effects, Filter Curve. Then, click Manage, Factory Presets, Bass Boost, and adjust the curve very slightly until you are happy with the results. If you already have a low, bassy voice, you may not need much boost here. From here, open the Filter Curve again. Click Manage, Factory Presets, Treble Boost. You will want to adjust this based on your personal vocal tone. Using the Compressor tool will help even out the levels in the recording and is especially helpful if you don't have a professional microphone. First, select the audio portion that you want to apply the effect to. Then, navigate to Effect, Compressor. For most podcasts and voice recordings, you should leave at default. Apply it to the track, play it back, and then make very small tweaks if necessary. After applying any effects, normalize your audio. This effect allows you to adjust the volume without affecting the dynamic range. Select the track you want to normalize and navigate to Effect, Normalize. For most podcasts and voice recordings, you should leave the settings at default. To export your finished project as an audio track, select File, Export, Export as MP3. Enter the name you would like to save it as well as your destination. For voice recordings, you should leave these settings at their default settings. Audacity will then prompt you to enter metadata tags. This is not necessary for personal use, but it is helpful if you are planning to upload to a streaming service like Spotify, Apple Music, or similar.